very detailed discussion. You've seen the recommendation put forward by Councillor Nolan and the one put forward by Councillor Gilchrist. We were trying to get some way of bringing them together, merge them in some way, because in essence, I think we agree on an awful lot of what's in Councillor Nolan. We agree that we need to look more closely at how Morton works. We agree we need to monitor more closely how the Gladstone or the change of provision of Gladstone work. 111 is untested as yet, whether that can cope. Pharmacies have struggled, we know, and the large portion of the service provision will depend on increased use of pharmacies. So we've got the same concerns. I'm afraid, as far as wording goes, I'm going to second Councillor Gilchrist's notice of motion. I'm going to put them both to the vote. I think it's the only way we couldn't reach agreement and try and merge them. So, Councillor Nolan, it's moved by you and seconded by Councillor Callan. All those in favour of that recommendation, please show. And Councillor Gilchrist, those against?
However, because of the brain. And the Mr. David Rich from Stagecoach attended. And we had a meeting with Jeanette Townsend from Mersey Travel and some of the staff. I'm quite happy that other councillors have to add to this account. This took place about a few weeks ago, and in the last 10 days perhaps, Mersey Travel, Jeanette Townsend circulated the results of Stagecoach's response to the consultation linked to all the councillors affected by certain routes, and the timetable goes live on, I think, the 1st of September or something like that. So, and clearly concerns remain about Prenton, and the councillor Muspratt about the routes down the A41. There might be a change one to replace the X8 and things like that. But when we have the timetables, I think we need to sit down with representatives from Stagecoach and the Weaver and look at the impact of changes to twist a few arms, quite frankly.
Well, can I suggest that we perhaps put it to pay to twist in the arms and ask if the cabinet member responsible for private transportation would like to be part of the group?
I think we've got to take into consideration, and I attended the meeting with Councillor Gilchrist, that it's not all about buses. We need an integrated transport solution. And you know, we need to look at all models on a multimodal basis. And I'm happy to take part in that. I've got big experience of working with Mersey Travel and transport issues right across with taxis as well. You know, we've got no control, as has been mentioned. Mersey Travel can only offer bus services with commercial operators. That was made clear to us at the meeting we went to, but the commercial operator said, I repeat it again, if we don't make £40 an hour on bus service, then it's not viable for us to run it. So Mersey Travel, in the older days, if you like, when there was more funding around, used to pick up them services and subsidise them. But Mersey Travel has got significant pressures on it from council levy is not going to Mersey Travel in the amount it used to because of austerity measures. So therefore, we've got almost a perfect storm with transport. And we're now seeing the fruits of that with bus services being withdrawn. But we have certainly got to take into consideration other modes of transport and how they can fit in and maybe fill the gaps before there's a big picture proposal from the combined authority, who now have the funding available from central government as part of the devolution deal.
Can I make a further suggestion then, given that this is a much bigger subject than just what affects Outland? It will need to be taken into consideration in the production of the local plan, most definitely will. That instead of, I don't know whether there's any terms of reference for this transport group, I think it's just put together. I think it's almost a bit of a rubber stamping exercise during a long period of consultation on something else somewhere ago. So my suggestion is that as chair of this committee, I write to the leader of the council and say that in this aspect it's been a concern over access to health facilities, but actually it's the same concerns over a number of facilities and transport, and will he oversee putting together of a transport group of the council, which will be drawn from members from, I think, business committee definitely will want to be, I think, sure, the environment, and I think probably Councillor Gray will probably want to be involved as well. So if committee's help is okay, you do that, I'll draft a letter and get it off to, okay? Okay, thanks again, everybody.